Okay, so anyone, any questions so far on what is dimension, what is fact, and then what is measure? Because these are like very important basics you need to understand before we move further.
No, sir.
Okay, so moving further, so we'll just try to understand. There are two type of tables as well, right? So similarly, how the columns are segregated in dimension modeling or data warehousing into two, dimension and facts. Similarly, the tables, right? When you take table, so those tables are primarily classified into two types of tables. One is a dimension tables and the other one is a fact table. So you need to understand, or generally, right? So who designs this dimension tables, or who considers, okay, when there is a new project, okay, this is what a dimension or this is what a fact, right? So generally, there will be data modelers at the database level, and they have like several meetings with the business teams. And then from there, data modelers are going to define, okay, this particular column will act as a dimension and this is going to act as a fact. But like as a MicroStrategy developer, when you do a reporting, you need to understand, okay, this tables is already designed by your data modelers. But when you look at that table, you need to understand, okay, this table is a dimension table or whether this table is a fact table. So on what basis we understand, or like whenever we look at that particular table, is like when you know certain guidelines, right, it will be very easy. We'll just try to understand each one of them in detail. So whenever we say dimension tables, right? So as we said, the dimension table contains dimensions. So generally, the descriptive or the textual fields. So whatever your customer name, customer address, store name, store address, store manager, your item name, and so on. So all these textual columns, right? So where they present is, they are going to present in the dimension tables. So, and this dimension tables provides descriptive or contextual information for the measurement of a fact table. So this particular thing we'll try to understand by taking out an example. And then a dimension table contains surrogate keys, natural keys, and a set of attributes. So as we discussed, right, so whenever we have some particular key columns, like say customer ID and then customer SSN. So we discussed basically, even though they are numeric, they are not facts because they don't impact business. So such numeric columns, which doesn't impact business, right? And still they exist. So they might be a key column, or they are like numeric in nature and part of dimension. So that we will also understand. So, but just remember, so all your key columns, like surrogate key, what is it? Or like primary key, we'll try to understand. So your surrogate keys and then primary keys will be part of your dimension tables. So that, like, probably in next 5 minutes, you'll try to understand that as well. And then dimension tables are also called as reference table. So why these are called reference tables, we will understand that as well. So just remember this particular points. So all these points, right, in like next 10, 15 minutes, you'll be very clear. And then similarly, on the fact tables also, we'll just go through them and try to get into details. So fact table mainly consist of business facts and then the foreign keys. So if you look at here, so it states that it contains surrogate keys and then the primary keys, whereas in case of your fact tables, so what it contains is, it contains foreign keys. So people who know primary foreign key, that's fine. If not, we'll see now. So, and then that refers to primary keys in the dimension table. So the fact table is referring the dimension table. Hence, the dimension tables are called as reference tables. So what is that referring? What is it referring? That we will understand here. And then fact table provides the measurement of an enterprise. So these fact tables are very important because all your amount fields, right? So they are present in fact tables on which we are going to group, or we are going to aggregate the data to create measures for an enterprise, means for a business organization. And this fact table contains a foreign key, then measurements, and then degenerated dimensions. So under types of dimensions, again, there are various classifications like confirmed dimension, shrink dimension, junk dimensions, and slowly changing dimension, and so on. So during that, we'll see what is degenerate dimension. And then a fact table normally contains two columns, one that contains the facts and the other foreign keys to the dimension tables. So all these points, right? So we'll take an example and then we'll revisit this particular thing. So whenever we say, for example, if you look at this diagram, right? So from here, all that particular point should be clear. So just look at this particular table here. So there is a table. In this particular table, there are like both, fact table and then the dimension tables as well. So generally, whenever you join any organization, they follow certain standard. So assume here that particular standard is wherever you see DIM, right? So those are dimension tables and FACT, that is a fact table. So if you look here in our example, whatever we have took to understand it. So we have four dimension tables and one fact table. So now look at this particular fact table. So this fact table, what it contains is, so if you look here, sales amount, sales price, sales quantity, right? So this sales quantity, sales price, sales amount, what are these three? So I'm not able to hear facts. You a little bit louder. So these are facts. Sales quantity is a fact, sales price is a fact, and sales amount is a fact. So your fact table contains facts. That point is clear, right?
Yes.
Okay. So just remember, you cannot have your facts stored in the dimension tables. So in the dimension tables, you'll not have any single fact. If at all in your project or somewhere it is there, then it is like, your data modeler has done a wrong design as such or a bad design. So your fact table should contain facts. That is one thing. And if you look here, so there is a date key, there is a customer key, there is a store key, there is a product key and so on. So, okay. And then there is a sale ID which acts as a primary key. So this is what called degenerate dimension. So we'll come back this at a later stage. But now try to understand this store key, then customer key, and then product key and so on. So we'll just take an example from there and then try to understand here. So say for example, in this particular example only, I have sales, profit, quantity and so on. So what I'm doing is basically, I'm just trying to say for example, add few columns here. So the customer ID is, so assume like every particular customer, right? So they have a unique ID. They have a unique ID. Say for example, C001, it can be a number or it can be a alphanumeric as well. So 001 and then I have like two and then three and so on actually. So in this way, so I have different customers and this particular customer, when he performs transactions more than once, his particular number will be duplicated. If you see one and then another one and another one. So is this a possibility, like same person comes to same store and he can purchase multiple times, or you provide a restriction that he has to purchase only one time? Hello?
He can do multiple times.
He can do multiple times because you need business and every particular customer has to come again and again, right? So on a similar fashion, so I'm just defining some particular numbers to my store as well. So for a store, right, when we take a store, when we take a customer and so on, right? So on that particular line, so just try to understand my question here. So when you take customer or when you take product or when you take any particular store. So for that particular thing, right? So what are the different columns that describes a customer? Or what are the different columns that defines a product? What are the different properties which defines a store? Properties as in, what are the different columns that can be part of a store? What are the different columns that can be part of a product and so on? So when we say customer, right? So what are the different attributes a customer can have? For example, is customer name is one attribute. And what else he can have?
Contact number.
Customer contact number. Then?
Address.
His particular address.
ID number.
Sorry, his birth date. Then what else?
Phone number.
Phone ID. Number. ID. So there are many different columns which defines customer. Agree?
Yes.
and then product. Assume like you purchase some item. So that particular item also has certain properties or no?
Yeah, they do have.
What are some of them?
The quantity or the quality and the number, like kind
item,
of
barcode. Item barcode, okay. So yeah, what else? The item color.
Yeah, color.
What is the size? All these things will present, yes or no? Similarly,
yes.
Store also. Store ID, who is the store manager? What is the store contact number? What is the store address? Store location?
Location.
Right?
Yes.
So, okay. So, whenever some customer is performing a transaction, so say for example, what do you think here? So, assume like I store his number is sufficient. So, duplicating his number is sufficient, or do you think all that 100 columns which defines customer, right? Even those has to be repeated here only.
It has to be repeated. If the person is same, it should be.
So assume like customer has 100 columns, product has 50 columns, store has another 25 columns. So total, assuming it comes to 175 or 200 columns, assume. So for every sales amount you're doing, so loading all these customer details and then repeating here is like a good practice, or just try to understand my question. Storing here my customer details, and then, so what I do is I create another table, and in my other table, so what I am doing is I'm having customer ID as well as I have customer name and all that 100 columns which defines them. And then what I do is, so this is my 01 customer, and I will store all his particular details, his particular name, his particular address, contact number, SSN, whatnot, all his particular details I'm going to store here. So now this is my customer. So what do you think? So defining all these 100 columns here, or defining only once here, and then from here to reference here is a good practice.
The second one is good one.
So assume like what happens if I define all that information in this table is there will be a lot of duplication. The customer name will be repeated. Like say for example, on a year, when you take a year, so this particular customer might come like 100 times to Walmart store. So on that particular lines, what happens? I'm unnecessarily repeating, or his name, address, and all other columns, I'm going to repeat it multiple times. Same the case with product and store. So what it tends is, when you store such amount of information, it is going to degrade the performance. It is going to degrade the performance. If there is lot of columns, lot of duplicates in a table, then whenever you hit this particular table, it degrades the performance. Agree, everyone?
Yes.
So for that particular lines, what you do is in the fact tables, so you are going to have your facts as well as you will have only the IDs. You do have only the IDs. So you do have IDs, and even though this IDs gets duplicated, that's fine. A customer X does multiple transactions, then his particular ID gets repeated. But you want to see who is this customer, right? Then what you do is from here, you reference to this customer and you want whatever. So you want his name, you want his contact number, what are details you want about customer. So that is going to present in the customer table, in the customer table. So in your dimension table, you will have key column. And similarly, how you have customer table, like customer ID, customer name, address, and so on. Similarly, product also, you'll have separate table. So for product also, you'll have product ID, product name, and so on. So then store also, you have a separate table. So in this way, you do have, this is a key column, this is a key column, this is a key column. And to this key columns, you will have separate dimension tables where you have the descriptive data about that particular key column. Descriptive column about the key column. So getting everyone what I'm trying to say?
Yes.
So this is my what table? This is what table? This is my?
Fact table.
Fact table. So what fact table contains? What are these? These are my?
Columns.
Facts. Columns. Facts. These are my facts. So fact table contains facts as well as what the fact table contains is it is going to contain the key columns.
Okay.
They are going to contain the key columns. And for today's session, so just remember, so this key column now is duplicated or not? Customer one visits various times my store. So I have to repeat his particular thing. Yes or no?
Yes.
And then same customer 1 has purchased item 10. So there is a customer 10 who also purchased a product 10. Is this a possibility?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. And the same customer, right? He might visit the same store, assume. Like same store. So in this case, here if you look, store ID might get duplicated, product ID might get duplicated, and the customer ID also might get duplicated. All right. So this particular case, whatever you see in case of fact tables, so those keys will be foreign keys. So as of now, what is a foreign key means? So just remember, any key column which might have duplicates, which might have duplicates. If you look customer ID, does it have duplicates?
It's 1.
1 is duplicated. So I might have 2, 3. I mean, I'm given some reference, but it can have duplicates. Yes or no?
Yes.
Right. So this can have duplicates. Product can have duplicates. Store can have duplicates. So all the column, whenever it has duplicate, what type of key it is called means? It is called as a foreign key. So your fact table contains facts and it contains foreign keys. So is this point clear?
Yes.
Okay. So now when you take this customer table, so this customer ID, so every person should have a unique identification. Agree?
Yeah.
So for that one, so this customer ID here, it is defined as a primary key. It is defined as a what? A primary key. So what is a primary key means? It is a unique identification. So say for example, in this same column, you just try to add once again one, it will not allow. It will not allow because this is a constraint. Primary key is a constraint. So it ensures only the unique values are entered here. So whenever you try to enter once again one, then what happens is it is going to throw error, a duplicate index key, duplicate index key. So always here it is going to contain only what?
Unique value.
Unique values. So all your customer data will be present here. Similarly, as how you have seen customer table, you'll have product table, you'll have store table and so on. So in your dimension table, you'll have the key columns as well as the textual or the attributes which defines your facts. Okay, from here, so what happens is, so it is referencing. So why we call dimension tables as references? So I want to find, say for example, now out of my analysis, I found out that customer 2 has performed major sales. So I want to offer something. So I want to know his details. I want to know his name. I want to know his email address and so on. So this 2 is present here. So in order to get those details of customers, what I need to do is I need to take this 2 and go to which table? Customer table.
Dimension
table. I need to go and from there, so I need to get his particular details. Yes or no?
Yes.
So from here, fact table, I am referencing dimension table to get the descriptive data. Agree?
Yeah.
Everyone clear so far?
Yes.
Okay. So now let's go back to our particular diagram in the PowerPoint and we'll just try to understand from there. Okay. So if you look here, so this particular fact table contains facts and it contains foreign keys. Foreign keys means that duplicates. And this date key, right? What it is doing is it is referencing to the date table. And from the date table, you can get all other columns like month, year, month, number, and so on. Similarly, you have a product key, which is connecting to this one. And from there, you can get name and brand of the product. And similar fashion, it is connected to customer table and it is connected to the store table. So in case of your fact tables, you will have facts and then you'll have foreign keys. And in case of your dimension tables, you will have the primary keys and all your dimensions or descriptive values. You'll have the descriptive columns as well as any numeric column which doesn't impact business. Any numeric column which doesn't impact business. So those are also loaded here. Say for example, a customer age. So always it will be 35, 40 and so on. So on that lines, even that is going to be numeric, but it doesn't have impact on the business. So those columns also are going to store in the dimension tables. So what will be stored in a dimension table? Primary keys, textual columns and numeric columns, which doesn't impact business. So what will be stored in fact tables?
Foreign keys.
And the foreign keys. And from this foreign keys, so it will be referencing to what? It will be referencing to?
Dimension tables.
Dimension tables. Okay. So now knowing all these things, we'll just try to again try to understand this particular thing. So dimension tables mainly contains descriptive attributes or all that particular columns together, right? So attributes means property, descriptive columns that are textual fields. So we understood that textual fields. Dimension tables provides descriptive or contextual information for the measure. So what your dimension tables are doing is, so because from the fact table, when it references your dimension table, there only it is getting all the descriptive value. So that is where the word contextual, or it adds meaning to your measures. And a dimension table contains a surrogate key. So we'll understand what is surrogate key. But as of today, just assume surrogate key is like a primary key in data warehousing. So whatever primary key we define, so that is similar to surrogate key. And then it might have natural key and set of attributes or set of columns. And then dimension tables are also called references tables. The reason is every time from the foreign key, that is from the fact table, using that foreign key, it is going to reference your table, reference your dimension tables. And moving on to fact table. So fact tables mainly consist of business facts, so that we have seen, and foreign keys that refer to primary keys in the dimension tables. So you'll have foreign keys, and with that only you can refer to the primary keys. And fact tables provides the measurement of an enterprise. So because all your facts exist there, and on top of which you perform aggregation in order to give that measures to your business. Then fact table contains a foreign key, then measurements and degenerate dimensions. So you understood foreign keys, you understood measures, that is aggregation of facts. But degenerate dimensions we will see on the type of dimensions. So we'll hold for this one. So a fact table normally contains two columns, one that contains a fact and the other foreign keys to the dimension tables. Okay. So any questions, like whenever you look at the table, can you understand whether it is a dimension table or a fact table? Yes or no?
Yes.
So simple, like you look at the table, if you see any of the textual column, so at least one textual column, you understand that, okay, that is a dimension table. And you look a table which contains all the keys and which contains all the facts, right? So that particular table is a fact table. Clear, everyone?
Yes.
Okay. So, okay. So with that, right? So probably, we'll end today's session here. Before that, like, I just want to ask, one particular thing, right? Just to confirm me, how many people know, like, what is primary key, what is foreign key, or you don't know them?
I just know that primary key is a unique key, mm-hmm. and the foreign key is kind of fields.
What else? So what are like attributes or properties of a primary key and foreign key? So if someone asks you state differences between primary key and foreign key, right? What we can provide a definition?
Primary key is a set of columns.
No, one single column is a primary key, right? So say in case of our particular example, customer ID itself, that customer ID is a primary key.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes, please respond. At least no, don't know. I mean,
unique key. Will have unique.
Okay, foreign keys.
It's so okay.
Have duplicate values which refers to the other table. We can refer with help.
So, what are like other differences between them?
Primary key won't accept the null values.
Primary key doesn't accept null values. Okay, good. And foreign key accepts null values?
Yes, because...
No.
No means you want to add something? Someone said no, right? Yeah, go ahead, Nikhila. Yeah, you said like primary key accepts nulls and foreign
yeah,
key.
Yeah, so.
Sorry, primary key doesn't accept nulls and foreign key accept nulls. Okay.
So the thing is, the example which you gave, we have written like the same ID person, like it's 1111.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that is going to accept.
Okay.
Yeah. I just took that as an example.
Yeah. Okay. So null, what is null actually? Then in that case?
Zero.
No, zero is not null. Zero is zero only. So in database, null is a different. It is an unknown value.
Yeah.
Okay. Fine. Okay. So what I understood is a lot of people doesn't know primary key, foreign key, or null values, those concepts. Agree, everyone?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Sorry?
Oh, I said yes.
Yes, okay. Pranav, okay. So in that case, right? So, okay. So probably we'll take some time to understand that as well as part of our tomorrow session. So what is primary key? What is foreign key? And then you have seen something called as surrogate key. And there is another concept called as composite key. So under keys, these are the different keys. And we'll try to understand that. And a concept called as normalization and denormalization. So these are the other different concepts which we need to understand. So before we understand a data model as in how this table, the relationship, right? When we talk relationship, so say for example, in any project, right? So you will have, I mean, you don't have five tables or you don't have like two tables or three tables. So any project you get in, it will have 100 tables, it will have 80 tables, or it might have 200 and 300 tables. And whatever the business required, right? So the required data, what do you think is present in one table or it will present across multiple tables? So business has asked you to create a report. So that report, whatever data that is required, will exist in one table or it exists in like a group of tables?
Multiple tables.
So obviously in multiple tables. So whenever you need to bring data from multiple tables, right? So in that particular case, you need to understand this concept, primary keys and foreign keys, because between different tables, it is going to join. It is going to join or it is going to establish relationship between these keys only, primary key, foreign keys, surrogate keys, and then the composite keys.
Okay.
And then normalization and denormalization is something which is very important to understand how the model is there. Say, for example, in a data warehousing, when all these 200 tables are there, the relationship between these tables are done using a modeling called as star schema or snowflake schema. So that is the key thing. So any project you take, either that model has to be in star schema or it has to be a snowflake, or there is another thing called hybrid, which generally they don't use. But what is star and what is a snowflake, you need to understand it. So these two things, right? So we will just try to understand. So probably I thought like everyone knows this, but that's fine. So we'll take an hour extra to understand this in tomorrow session, and then probably on Friday we'll discuss on star schema and snowflake schema. So once we know till that point, right? So it is good to start with a tool. So there is one concept called as types of dimensions and then types of facts. So that probably over 1 weekend we'll try to understand them.
Sure.
So fine. So before we wind up today's session, right? So anyone have any questions? I can take it up for the next couple of minutes.
So you were telling that you'll be explaining the concepts like which on Friday. So is there any possibility to send with some descriptive type so that we can go through that and know before ahead?
Oh, really? Like if you do that, then probably every day I can send you.
Yeah, so we can.
This week plan I can, because I think a lot of people are busy and they don't find time. But if there are persons who want to browse, who want to do certain homework before the session, I'm very fine to send that particular notes. Probably from there, right, you can contribute to the session, add some more notes. That will be great as well. So probably I'll send out what is that we are going to discuss tomorrow, and then what we are going to discuss on Friday.
Yeah, sure.
So yeah, I'll send after the session now.
Yeah, thank you.
No problem. Any others have any questions?
No, Srinivas.
About Rajesh, Pranav?
No.
So, okay then, guys. Thanks all for your time. We'll catch up tomorrow, and probably on what concepts we'll be discussing tomorrow and day after, I'll be sending over them in our group.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, Sri.
Yeah. Thanks, everyone. Bye. Good night.
Bye.